Well, our next guest has been called America's pastor, but he could also be dubbed America's author. Max Lucado has more than 100 books to his name, many of them bestsellers. And in his latest, he calls himself a recovering prayer wimp. Take a look.
According to recent studies, more people in America will pray in 1 week than will exercise or go to work. Even then, Pastor Max Lucado says many people wish their prayer lives were stronger. The problem, he says, is that people get distracted or they're uncertain about praying. In fact, he struggled with the same things until he learned some practical steps that helped him focus his prayers. In his new book, Before Amen, Max shares a simple system that will help you pray more clearly and effectively.
Well, Max Lucado is here with us now, and Max, we welcome you back to the
700 Club. Thank you. It's really a treat. I always love coming back.
Well, we always love when you have a new book that comes out because they're so just enriching to all of us. But before we talk about your new book, Before Amen, you just penned an op-ed for USA Today that I want to mention that addressed and defended the rights of a Muslim football player to pray to Allah. Tell us about that, because people were surprised that there was a call on the play that they lost 15 yards. Tell me about your op-ed piece and why.
Yeah, it was curious that such a big deal was made out of a person just taking time to pray.
And it wasn't a great big flamboyant.
Exactly. It was his way of demonstrating his faith and his prayer. And I think we've got to be careful as a society that we don't begin dismantling what is for many a great source of strength and faith.
Yes.
Here was a person simply expressing their own faith, whether you agree or disagree with their reasoning or faith, and not being allowed to do so.
Yeah.
And to the NFL's credit, they pulled the pin. They said that it was a mistake.
Yes.
You know,
and to defend the right of someone to do that is to defend our right as well.
Absolutely. What we're talking about here is simply a free expression of religious faith, and we've got to always protect that, right?
Yes.
Regardless
of
our religious persuasion, we've got to stand guard over that, and so that's why I thought it important to step up and applaud him
for
doing so.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's talk about Before Amen. You call yourself a recovering prayer wimp. What do you mean by that?
I've always struggled with prayer. By the way, I've always appreciated you guys and your emphasis on prayer. I know you just finished a prayer week, but I've struggled with prayer. I've met people who would say, oh, I get up at 4 a.m. and I pray till 7 a.m. I've met people who told me about their 40-day prayer retreat. But I got to tell you, Terry, I've just always battled. I've been one of these guys who would rather do something for God than spend time talking to God.
Yeah. Well, in some ways, busyness is sort of the trademark of Americans these days.
It is.
You say that the Bible's teachings on prayer can kind of be boiled down to a six-sentence framework that you call the pocket prayer. Talk about that.
And this is what helped me, and this is why I collected this in a book, because every book I'd read was written for prayer warriors.
Yeah.
So I wrote a book for prayer wimps. what I did is I took all the prayers in the Bible, and I realized they would fit neatly into one of six stanzas. Father, you are good. Mm-hmm. I need help. They need help. Thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah. You know, I think one of the reasons that people love you so much, Max, is because you relate to the common person and you make us feel like there's hope. You know, I want you to talk about the father fact, because, you know, addressing God as Father just personalizes the whole thing in such a different way.
Mm. Jesus taught us, right? When you pray, pray like this: Our Father who art in heaven. Of all the things for Jesus to do, when he taught us to pray, he said, talk to God like you would a father.
Yeah.
A father is one who protects, one who provides, one who hears. And as most of us have studied, the word there for father is Abba, which is the most tender pedestrian word for father. And so it's just an invitation to a tender conversation with our Heavenly Father.
And then you say, you are good. Mm. Knowing God is good is so significant.
I really battled. How do you summarize all the declarations in the Psalms? And it seems to me that all of them can fit under this umbrella statement, you're good. Mm-hmm. You're just good. Mm-hmm. Not only are you strong, not only are you mighty, you're good. You mean good. You do good. You are good. So if you can begin a prayer by declaring God is your Father, but God is good. Mm-hmm. I think we've done a lot. We've just anchored ourselves to the two great discoveries of the Bible.
You know, I think one of the things that you always hear asked from people whose prayers haven't maybe been answered in the way they had hoped is, how do I know God is good? How do I know He sees me, hears me, cares about me?
Yeah. And one of the problems we have with prayer is that unanswered prayers hinder us.
Yes.
You know?
In a sense, they're not really unanswered, are they?
Exactly, exactly. They're just simply not answered according to our timeline. Mm-hmm. What I think is important, Terry, is to go to these stories in the Bible where Jesus responds to people's requests. One of my favorite is Mary, the mother of Jesus, who mm-hmm. came to Him at the wedding that had no wine.
Yes.
And said, they have no more wine. Yeah. Couldn't be more simple request.
Yeah.
And the impression is Jesus did not come to that wedding with the intention of performing a miracle, but because she came with the honest request, it impacted His actions.
And you say, and I think this addresses that, we do not change God's intention, but we can influence His actions.
Isn't that amazing? This is the stunning discovery in Scripture. Everything from Moses praying for the children of Israel, you know, on Mount Sinai, and the Scripture says, and God changed His mind.
Yeah.
To that story we just referred to, there is something about our intercession. But we parents get this, don't we?
Yes, we do.
When our children come to us with a fair and appropriate, not irresponsible, but a fair and appropriate mm-hmm. request, we might move more quickly on something.
Yeah.
Or we might give them more than we originally intended.
Mm-hmm.
Our Heavenly Father wants to bless. He wants to help. I think He's just waiting on us to pray.
Yeah. It's such a wonderful book because it brings God so close,
I hope so.
You know, and prayer is really the thing. It's just talking to
it
Him.
Is.
It's the communication. It's the relationship. Well, it's another wonderful Max book. It's called Before Amen, The Power of a Simple Prayer. And you can read it for more stories. You need to get a hold of it. There's even a study guide in it. It's just been released in stores nationwide. So get your copy. Beautiful cover as always too, Max. I mean, you've got a great package there, The Power of a Simple Prayer.
You.
Before Amen.
It's so
Bless
good to
you.
See
thank
you.
Thank you. It's wonderful to have
thank you
here.